Okay, so we would like to call upon Dr. Divya Palanisamy. She is a neurosurgeon from Chennai, India. She will be talking about an introduction and orientation to Fujita Fellowship. Dr. Divya, this is all yours now.
Yeah, hi. Yeah. So I'm Dr. Divya. I'm from India. I did my fellowship at Fujita from March to May 2018. I thank Professor Yoko Kato for giving me this opportunity to talk. And I'm going to give a talk today, which will give an orientation to the fellowship at Fujita. Okay. So the aim of this fellowship is to train the young residents and young neurosurgeons from developing countries and also underdeveloped countries. So it is also to give an exposure for them to various subspecialties and advanced techniques which are practiced in Japan. So the fellowship, usually the duration is 1 to 3 months, and they provide you with a free accommodation in a stereotype department, which is located very near the hospital. And they provide you with scholarship money, but that is given at the end of your fellowship. So when you come to Japan for the fellowship, you have to arrange for the money in Japanese money, like yen, as cash or a visa card, and you will be reimbursed at the end of your fellowship. So flight ticket is our responsibility, and there is no travel expense involved because the apartment is very near to the hospital. So this is the Banbunten Hospital, which was built as the first building of the Fujita Health University. And this is the view which is taken from the railway station. So what are the images I have taken, I'm presenting today. So, and this is the stereotyped apartment. So it has a water kettle, and it has an electric cooker, and it has a mini fridge. And you have also an electric stove, so you can cook your own food. And during winter seasons, especially from September to March, it's better you bring blankets and sweaters and jackets and everything. It will be very, very cold. And so how to apply for the fellowship? So you have to go to the WFN's website. You have to do online application. You have to send. So go to www.wfns.org. Go to fellowship application, select Fujita, and that will give you the details of the program and what are the documents that are required for the application. You can apply, there is a link for online application, and also you can contact Professor Yoko Kato in this email ID, neuron2@fujita.hucjp and ykato@fujita.hucjp. Okay, so actually this fellowship is very busy. The schedule is very busy. Like they accept 3 fellows at a time. So you may get the reply from the secretary, Ms. Toshiko knows. But you will get the fellowship after 6 months or 1 year, since the schedule are always almost filled. So wait for the reply from Toshiko knows. So once you join the fellowship, so it's very busy there. So be ready to become a busy bee. So the work starts on Monday morning at 7:30 a.m. with presentation of the cases for the week. What are the cases which are posted for surgery the next week and the other weeks? They're all written in the board in the fellow room. So you have to get the UHID and put it in the computer, get the images of the patients. Fellow has to make a PowerPoint presentation of all those cases. And the fellow has to do CFD, that is computational fluid dynamics, for the aneurysm patients. Those images should also be incorporated into the PowerPoint, and that will be discussed on the Monday morning. So Tuesday morning, 7:30, we have journal club meeting. That is also comes in rotation. The fellows have to do that in rotation. And Tuesdays, Wednesdays, Thursdays are operation theater days. So if you are interested, with permission of Professor Kato, you can assist for the surgeries. On the same day, the surgery videos should be edited, because professor will present those edited videos to the patient and the attenders the next day morning. So that is very important, the video editing. So on Friday morning at 7:30 a.m. There is a discussion will be happening on the edited surgical videos, and also the surgical steps are discussed, and which is followed by a short quick ward runs. And video editing is important. The fellow has to bring a laptop, and a good video editor should be downloaded before going to Japan. That is very, very important. And if you are interested in other surgeries, professor will arrange for that, like functional surgeries and all. She will find out which hospital they are doing, and she will allow you to visit those hospitals to visit those surgeries, to see those surgeries. And they provide you with some travel allowances also. And your fellow is expected to present, means write at least one paper during the fellowship. And if professor is organizing seminars and conferences, like, you have to help her in organizing this, which will help you. So these are the means expectations from the fellows, like routines of a fellow. So what you can learn as a fellow from Fujita University. So yes, we are there to learn the management of neurosurgical cases. You will also learn how to means do computational fluid dynamics. I will come to that. And how to draw the aneurysms. And you can see different surgical instruments which are not available outside Japan. And you can also learn how to do microvascular anastomosis, and you have to learn many for the many fellows. That is a place where they learn how to write a paper. So, and there is a good library with good books and articles. You can access it, and you have access to JNS also, and you can develop your organization skills. I will come to each with my experience. So yes, vascular surgery, we are there. Mainly vascular surgery is done, performed there. So both surgical and intravascular, you can see there. And means many surgical techniques like antricular endarterectomy, Sylvian Fischer opening, exposure of trinoidal segment of ICA, jugular tubercle resection, many surgical things, steps you will learn. Also, they do revascularization, carotid endarterectomy, MVD, and all those things you are able to see. And endovascular procedures like coiling. And means the one which was interesting to me was middle meningeal artery occlusion for recurrent chronic subdural hematomas. So more than one recurrence they do this procedure. And this is the external carotid artery angiogram. You see the internal meningeal artery, means internal maxillary artery. This is the middle meningeal artery. You see the anterior branch and the posterior branch. So they are filled with means onyx. So it's not seen. So this was quite interesting for me. So you will also get to see many like this. And they also perform endoscopic surgery. They have an endoscopic arm, means robotic endoscopic arm. So you can see to that. And they do perform spine surgeries, skull base surgery, tumor surgeries. And you can visit specialized centers. So they practice in Japan. They practice subspecialty practice is there. So you can see the giants, big consultants in particular field. And apart from this, like you will learn how to do CFD, computational fluid dynamics. So it has four parameters: the pressure within the aneurysm, wall shear stress, vector and magnitude of the aneurysm, and velocity within the aneurysm. So this is a CFD for a basilar apex aneurysm. So the pressure is very high, and the vector, the magnified view of the vector. Here, actually, if the vectors are parallel to the aneurysmal wall, that means the wall is very thin. And if the vectors are diverging, that area, this the wall is thick. So in Japan, actually, we get to see more of unruptured aneurysms in elderly patients. So they do routine screening for all these patients. That's how they diagnose. So ruptured aneurysms are not common, means not very common in Japan, since they do the screening. So in these patients who are diagnosed during screening, so the CFD helps to know about whether to operate now or wait and watch. So this high pressure with thin-walled aneurysms, they operate. So this CFD is done for MVD cases like trigeminal neuralgia, hemifacial spasm, and glossopharyngeal neuralgias. So this is to see the area of contact, whether a contact of vessel to the nerve is there or not, that is identified with CFD. And this is the one of the right trigeminal neuralgia patient. So you see the superior cerebellar artery forming a loop and compressing on the root entry zone of the fifth nerve. And this CFD for these MVD patients is a little bit difficult, because we have to isolate the offending vessel. So that needs some training and time. It takes some time. So you dissect the vessel, and this is after the CFD, this is the point, the red dot is the point where the contact is there. So this patient had a very good recovery after the decompression. So, and you also get to see use of intraoperative adjuncts like endocyanine green angiography and dual imaging video angiography, which is a recently introduced a technique where the vessel with the dye actually looks green on the screen. So we can see the real-time relationship of the vessel to the adjacent structures. Perforators are all well seen. So endoscopy is commonly used in all the clipping patients to see whether the perforators are included in the clip and whether the neck, means there is residual neck at the end of the tip of the clip. So not to leave any residual neck of the aneurysm. So endoscopy is commonly used there, and I have seen brain oximetry used for carotid endarterectomy, and also they routinely use neurophysiological monitoring. All those things you can see and learn at Fujita. And this is one of the right CEA, and actually after the clipping, right side oxygen saturation was good, so there was no need for shunt. So this is aneurysm drawing. Actually, this was drawn by Dr. Ricky Tanaka, who was a senior resident at Fujita. He was there when I was doing my fellowship. So this this drawing of the aneurysm, the intraoperative view of the aneurysm, actually helps the residents to get an orientation during the surgery. So this takes 2 to 3 hours, but it really gives a good orientation. So you can learn this drawing also from there, and they have a separate book for that, how to do this drawing. And you can also get to see lots of surgical instruments, I told you. So the thing means two instruments were quite interesting for me, like the rubber hook retractor. Actually, this retractor, they are using it to retract the skin, and then they use the same for retracting the muscle and also the dura. So there is no need for any assistant to retract, means retract. So this is very useful. And this is the instrument which is used for endoscopic surgery. Dr. Watanabe, he's the endoscopic neurosurgeon. So after excision of the pituitary tumor, he closes the dura, he sutures the dura. So to push the knot inside, he uses this instrument. So it was quite interesting for me. So you will get to see all those. And this is, you can also learn microvascular anastomosis, because we have a microscope. This is Dr. Niranjana, one of the fellows. And we have a microscope. So she's doing this learning how to do the anastomosis there. They provide you with the instruments and 10-0 or 9-0 suture material and all. So that is also one good experience for you. And then we have a good library, and you can use it for writing articles. And there are lots of surgical videos recorded in the hard disk for many years. So if you can access those videos, and you can store it in a hard disk. So better you bring one TV hard disk, that will be really useful. And editing the surgical videos actually gives you a good experience, like it rehearses, revises the surgical steps that you have seen. So, and attending, if there are conferences happening in Japan, like professor will ask you to make the presentation, so it's a good opportunity for you to present posters or papers. So articles, you are expected to write an article. So I thank Professor Kato for motivating me to write these two papers, and these two got published, means accepted for publication in World Neurosurgery. So organizing skills, you can also develop organizing skills, because when they conduct seminars and conferences, you are the one who has to do all the arrangements for that. So it helps you. And if you are good at organizing skills, actually professor promotes you to be the member of organization. Professor I. Chirayan is the Counselor General of ACNS, who was a past fellow of Fujita, and Dr. Balamurugan, Dr. Ahmed Ansari, they're all important members of the executive committee of ACNS. They are also past fellows of Fujita. And training of residents, like it was good to see that he's Dr. Miyatani, a young resident, like he's working under the microscope, dissecting the exposing the aneurysm, dissecting the Sylvain fissure. Actually, Dr. Yamada, who is the assistant professor, will be around, and they wait for the residents to see, until the resident asks that please take over and help me out, so he doesn't disturb the resident. This is the way they train the residents. So he is Ricky Tanaka, who was a senior resident there. And at the end of his training at Fujita, professor gave him an ophthalmic aneurysm clipping. Like he did the anterolectomy, and he exposed the dural rings, and he opened the distal dural ring, and he clipped the ophthalmic aneurysm. It was inspiring, and it's a good, different way of teaching I have seen in Japan. And these are all the other photographs that I have taken. We have taken Dr. Harakuchi and Dr. Ota. They are the endovascular neurosurgeons, and this is lunch with Professor Sano, and I was privileged to assist Dr. Takizawa, the skull base surgeon, the best skull base surgeon. So on the first day of my fellowship, so and he it means for a BA PICA aneurysm surgery clipping. So like he taught me, he was so kind enough to means teach each and every step of clipping from skin opening. So and this is the fellow room. And Dr. Mayur Kamath from India and Dr. Fumin from Russia. So I'm thankful to both of them who helped me a lot during my fellowship career. And actually, you get to know many people from Uzbekistan, Russia, many places like Thailand and all. So you develop lots of contacts with consultants and other fellows. That's a good experience. And apart from academics, there are lots of places to visit in Japan. You must be knowing, like this is the Buddha temple, and this is one palace, and lots of palaces, lots of temples are there. And this is a temple located in the hill. So the view from the hill is very beautiful. And there is a big aquarium. This is the outside view, and there are lots of events happening in the aquarium. This is one of that the dam is performance by the dolphins. And food and travel, actually, professor is very kind enough to provide lots of snacks and noodles to the fellows that will be available in our fellow room. So for vegetarians who likes means who eats eggs, means they will be able to manage in Japan. But pure vegetarians, it's very difficult. So I suggest them to take their own food and cook for themselves. For non-vegetarians, Japanese love food, and there are lots of restaurants in and around the hospital, in every place. Every street has at least two restaurants, and they have lots of different country restaurants. So for Indians, so there are two restaurants at walkable distance, and there is a departmental store nearby. You can you can buy whatever you want for your house. And language, yes, it's they don't speak much of English. So that may be a problem, but I suggest you to download Google Translate before you come to Japan. So that will help you a lot. And Japanese are very kind people. So if you seek for help, even though they cannot communicate, means they cannot speak in English, they will try to help you out. So they're very nice people. And the transport system, that they have a very good railway system. So there is a railway station which is located near our hospital, and they provide you provide the fellows with cycles, so you can cycling also use it. And buses also available, but common mode of transportation is the train. And it's a very safe country, especially for women. Actually, we can walk on the road at 1 p.m. in the night. Nothing happens. So seek for help. They are very kind people. They will be ready to help you. So Professor means very often takes you to the restaurants. And this is a photograph taken after the lunch. And this is a dinner. And this is a small restaurant near the hospital. So apart from all this, you can see the hard work by the Japanese people. And they give more respect for the elders and their teachers. And it's very impressive. And the cleanliness and the self-discipline, they maintain the queue and all those things. And they are very well organized. If you take the road or anything, it is very well organized. So you get to know about all those things in Japan. So this is my last day at Fujita. Actually, at the end, last day, you will be provided with a valuable certificate from Professor Yoke Kato. And also you can get a recommendation letter. So I am, this is a doctor, this is Assistant Professor Dr. Yamada, and a Miyatani resident, and Professor Kavasi. And I thank all of them for their support during my fellowship. And this is the farewell party. She's Toshiko knows, and she will help you a lot during your fellowship. You will get to know once you join the fellowship. And so Fujita is a place of it's filled with lots of opportunities. So it's up to you to make use of it. And this is the temple near the hospital. So welcome to Fujita to see the dance of science. Thank you.